Fens occur where rainwater hits calcium-rich rock, here chalk, resulting in mineral-rich water. Furthermore, the water in the rainwater reacts with the calcium carbonate to create bicarbonate, and that acts as a pH buffer, meaning the water is neutral. Then as the water table reaches the level of the ground, it comes out, either as springs or often just seeps through the rocks. So fens are wet, base-rich habitats. As the water is just seeping through the habitat, there's very little oxygen in it, and so the material rots away very slowly, creates these peats. So a lot of the nitrogen and phosphorus and potassium in this system is locked up as peat. Furthermore, the calcium in the water locks up more of the phosphorus. So this is a nutrient poor community. So the species that occur here are species that can tolerate low nutrient, low oxygen, calcium carbonate rich conditions. Furthermore, there's a diversity of habitats here due to variation in geology and hydrology and disturbance. So you have open water and fens and woodlands. So there's a great diversity of different habitats here. But they're threatened because once they're drained, they have a reliable water supply, they're neutral, they're base rich, they have lots of organic material, so they make great farmland. So only 2% of fens still exist. Maintaining them requires very carefully managing the hydrology and the nutrient condition and the disturbance.